गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट डायोड एप्लीकेशंस। सो इट इज योर थर्ड इन इट। सो डायोड एप्लीकेशंस, इन दिस यू आर हैविंग रेक्टिफाइज, फिल्टर्स, क्लिपर्स, क्लिपिंग सर्क्यूट्स, क्लैंपिंग सर्क्यूट्स, डिटेक्टर्स, voltage doubler and all these topics. In the rectifiers, again you have half wave rectifier, full wave rectifier, bridge rectifier. The filters, we have inductor filters, capacitor filters, L section filters, pi filters. Okay, so these are the topics in the third unit. Today we will discuss about rectifiers. So what is a rectifier? See here, it is a block diagram of a regulated power supply. It is a block diagram of regulated power supply. So it consists of step down transformer, rectifier section, filters, regulators. Okay, it converts this converts AC to DC. This converts AC to DC signal. First of all, the AC signal is applied to the step down transformer. Then it is given to the rectifier section. In the rectifier section, it converts AC to pulsating DC signal. The pulsating DC signal is applied to the filter section. In this filter, we are going to minimize the AC components. Finally, it is applied to regulator section. So after regulators, we are getting the pure DC signal. Pure DC signal. So this sinusoidal signal, see here, this sinusoidal signal is applied to the step down transformer. After rectifier section, we are getting this waveform. After filter section, we are getting this waveform. After regulator section, we are getting the pure DC. After regulator section only, we are getting the pure DC. So it converts AC to DC signal. So regulated power supply, it converts the AC to pure DC signal. First we will see what is step down transformer. See here, it is a step down transformer. So it is a primary coil, it is a secondary coil. See here, input voltage, it is a pure sinusoidal signal. It is applied to the primary. So the turns of the primary is more compared to the turns of the secondary. The turns of the primary is more compared to the turns of the secondary. So it is a step down transformer. Here the input voltage is going to decrease. So that depends on the voltage depends on the number of turns. So from this figure, here V1 is greater than V2 and N1 is greater than N2. So input voltage, so primary voltage is V1, secondary voltage is V2. The primary turns are N1 and the secondary turns are N2. Here V1 is greater than V2, so the primary voltage is greater than the secondary voltage and the primary turns is greater than the secondary turns. So N1 is greater than N2. So this we can add V1 by N1 equal to V2 by N2. For example, if V1 is 230 volts, N1 is 100 turns and N2 is 5. So from this, the secondary voltage V2 will be 11.5 volts. So the primary voltage is 230 volts. So that is V1 is 230 volts and the secondary voltage V2 is 11.5 volts. So it is going to down the voltage. It is going to decrease the voltage. So 230 volts is converted into 11.5 volts. That based on the number of turns. So that is the step down transformer function. right? So in the regulated power supply, the first block is the step down transformer. So that 230 volts main voltage, the 230 volts is converted into some lower voltage that depends on the number of turns. So after transformer section, the output of the transformer, the output of the step down transformer is applied to the rectifier section. So the rectifier is an electronic device that converts AC to pulsating DC. Pulsating in the means the output of the rectifier contains both AC and DC signals. So the input of the rectifier is pure AC, but the output of the rectifier, it contains both AC and DC signals. So that's why the rectifier converts AC to pulsating DC signals. For rectification purpose, we are using the semiconductor diodes. So semiconductor diodes are used as rectifying elements. So the output of the rectifier is applied to filter section. So filter is a circuit that is used to reduce the ripple content, that is used to reduce the AC content present in the rectified output. So the rectified output contains both AC and DC signals. So to reduce that AC content, we are using the filters. So to minimize the ripple content in the output, filter circuit is used. In the filter circuits, we can use capacitor filter or inductor filter. So next, the output of filter is applied to the regulator. So to get the constant voltage, to obtain the constant voltage, regulator is used in the output stage. To obtain the constant voltage, regulator is used in the output stage. Okay, so that is the block diagram of the regulated power supply. Next, we will see the classification of rectifiers. Rectifiers are classified into two types. There are half wave rectifier, full wave rectifier. So again, full wave rectifier can be divided into two types: full wave center diode full wave rectifier, and full wave bridge rectifier. So it is half wave rectifier circuit. So rectifier converts AC to pulsating DC. In the rectifier circuits, we are using the semiconductor diodes. See here, it is a half wave rectifier circuit. It contains the step down transformer at the input side. The step down transformer is there. So the output of transformer is applied to the PN junction diode, and the load resistor is connected in the output side. So it is the input waveform. So half wave rectifier uses only one diode. So it converts the AC voltage to the pulsating DC voltage during positive half cycle of the applied AC voltage. So during the positive half cycle, it converts AC to pulsating DC voltage. So that is a function of the half wave rectifier. So half wave rectifier uses only one diode. So it has center diode, it has transformer, step down transformer, and the PN junction diode. So half wave rectifier uses only one diode. It converts the AC voltage to pulsating DC voltage. So during the positive half cycle, it converts the AC voltage to pulsating DC voltage. See here, the input waveform and the output waveform of the half wave rectifier. So it is the input waveform and it is the output waveform. Here it utilizes only half of the cycle and the remaining half cycle is wasted. The half wave rectifier utilizes only half of the cycle. So that's why it is called half wave rectifier. The remaining cycle is wasted. During the positive half cycle of the input voltage, during the positive half cycle of the input voltage, see here. So end A becomes positive with respect to end B. The diode D is forward biased. The diode D is forward biased and acts as a short circuit. The diode D is forward biased and acts as a short circuit. Then the current flows in the circuit. So in the positive half cycle, during the positive half cycle, so here A becomes positive with respect to B. See in this circuit, A becomes positive with respect to B. So then the diode is forward biased and it acts as a short circuit. So here D1 acts as a short circuit. Then the current flows in the circuit. Here the load voltage V0 equal to IL into RL. So the load current is flowing through RL. Then the load voltage V0 equal to IL into RL. So let VI equal to VM sin theta and V0 equal to VI equal to VM sin theta in between 0 to pi. Here in between 0 to pi, V0 equal to VI, right? So if you compare the input waveform and the output waveform, in between 0 to pi only, that means in the positive half cycle, V0 equal to VI, that is equal to VM sin theta. VM is the maximum voltage. So in between 0 to pi. For negative half cycle, so during the negative half cycle of the input voltage, so A becomes negative with respect to B. A becomes negative with respect to B. Then the diode is reverse biased and it acts as a open circuit. So in the negative half cycle, diode is reverse biased and it acts as a open circuit. Then there is no current flowing in the circuit. So the load voltage will be zero. Right? So here in the negative half cycle, the load voltage V0 equal to 0 volts. From pi to 2 pi, see here, from pi to 2 pi, there is no output. From pi to 2 pi, there is no output. Only from 0 to pi only, V0 equal to VI. From pi to 2 pi, V0 equal to 0. Because there is no current flowing in the circuit. The diode is in the reverse biased condition. It acts as an open circuit. So there is no current flowing in the circuit. So that's why the output voltage will be 0 in the negative half cycle. See here the input and output waveforms. So in the positive half cycle, so it is the input waveform, so it is the output waveform. In the positive half cycle, we are getting the same in the output section also. But in the negative half cycle, there is no output in the negative half cycle. So there is no output in the negative half cycle. So these are the input and output waveforms of the half wave rectifier. Input and output waveforms of the half wave rectifier. So here the important parameters of the rectifier are efficiency, ripple factor, peak inverse voltage, output efficiency. Here we need to calculate efficiency, the ripple factor, the peak inverse voltage, peak inverse voltage and the output frequency. First of all, so we will find DC current or average current, IDC or I average. So DC current or average current. See here. In the half wave rectifier, IDC equal to 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi IL d omega t. So here IL equal to IM sin omega t. The load current is IM sin omega t. So it is IDC equal to 1 by 2 pi, the DC current or average current. So IDC is 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi, the limits 0 to 2 pi IL d omega t. So 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi, where IL equal to Im sin omega t. Im sin omega t. So in the half wave rectifier, from 0 to pi only, from 0 to pi, the load current flows in, the current flows in the circuit. From pi to 2 pi, there is no current flows in the circuit. So that's why here, there is no current in the pi to 2 pi period. So that's why, so we have 1 by 2 pi 0 to pi Im sin omega t d omega t plus pi to 2 pi 0 d omega t. So from pi to 2 pi, there is no current flowing in the circuit. So that's why it becomes 0. See here. So from this equation, we get Im by 2 pi integral 0 to pi sin omega t d omega t. So Im by 2 pi, so minus cos omega t 0 to pi, minus cos omega t 0 to pi. Here, so minus Im by 2 pi cos pi minus of cos 0, cos pi minus of cos 0. So it becomes minus Im by 2 pi minus 1 minus 1, so it becomes minus 2, right? So minus Im by 2 pi minus 2. So finally it is 2 Im by 2 pi, and the DC current or average current IDC becomes Im by pi. Okay, so it is the DC current or average current in the half wave rectifier. It is Im by pi, where Im is the maximum current. See here. So IDC is 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi IL d omega t. So from 0 to pi, the current is flowing through the circuit. So that's why we have taken Im sin omega t. From pi to 2 pi, there is no current flowing through the circuit. So it becomes 0. Okay. So it is the average current or DC current in the half wave rectifier. That is IDC equal to Im by pi. Next, average voltage or DC voltage. So it is VDC or V average. Average voltage or DC voltage. So V equal to I into R. So the DC voltage VDC equal to IDC into RL. Here in the half wave rectifier, IDC equal to Im by pi. So IDC equal to Im by pi, substitute. So Im by pi into RL. So then it becomes Vm by pi, right? So IDC equal to Im by pi, and Im equal to Vm by RL. And VDC equal to Vm by pi. So that is the average voltage or DC voltage. Average voltage or DC voltage. Next, RMS value, RMS current, that is IRMS, RMS current, IRMS. So how to find out this IRMS? So IRMS is 1 by 2 pi square root of 1 by 2 pi is the root mean square value, root mean square value, 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to pi IL square d of omega t. So square root of 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi, where IL equal to Im sin omega t whole square d omega t. Square root of 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi Im square sin square omega t d omega t. So it becomes Im square 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi. So it becomes 1 minus cos 2 omega t. Sin square omega t becomes 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2 d omega t. If you apply the limits here, 0 to pi and pi to 2 pi, so it becomes square root of Im square by 4 pi, so theta minus sin 2 omega t by 2, limits 0 to pi, from pi to 2 pi it becomes 0. So sin square theta equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2, okay? So from this we get square root of Im square by 4 pi. So apply the limits. Then finally we get IRMS equal to Im by 2. It is the AC current. So the DC current is Im by pi, and the AC current is Im by 2, Irms equal to Im by 2. So next one is RMS value of load voltage, VRMS. This we can write VRMS equal to IRMS into RL. So we know that IRMS is Im by 2 in the half wave rectifier into RL, and Im equal to Vm by RL. So if you substitute here, then it becomes Vm by 2 RL into RL. So RL gets cancelled, then VRMS equal to Vm by 2. VRMS equal to Vm by 2. So it is the RMS value of load voltage, VRMS. Next, the DC output power. So PDC, the DC output power, PDC is, this we can write IDC square into RL, P equal to I square into RL, that is IDC square into RL. So in place of IDC, we can write Im by pi. So it becomes Im by pi whole square into RL, that is Im square by pi square into RL. Im equal to Vm by RL. So in place of Im, we can write Vm by RL. So it becomes Vm by RL whole square into 1 by pi square into RL. So the PDC is Vm by pi whole square into 1 by RL. That is the DC output power. Similarly, the AC output power is PAC. So it is IRMS square into RL. So here IRMS is Im by 2. So then it becomes AC output power PAC is Im by 2 whole square into RL. Okay. So these are the DC output power and AC output power. Next, efficiency, rectifier efficiency. The rectifier efficiency, it is defined as the ratio of output DC power to the AC input power. Here the input power is AC power and the output power is DC power. So the efficiency is defined as the ratio of output DC power to the AC input power. So it is DC output power by AC input power. It is PDC by PAC. So we know that PDC is Im square by pi square into RL, and PAC is Im square by 4 into RL. So then it becomes 0.406. So efficiency is 40.6% in the half wave rectifier. So in the half wave rectifier, maximum 40.6% AC power gets converted into DC power. The remaining 60% of the AC power is wasted. So in the half wave rectifier, the efficiency is only 40.6%. It is the main drawback of the half wave rectifier. The efficiency is only 40.6%. It utilizes only half of the signal, and the remaining half of the signal is wasted. Okay. Next, how to find out the ripple factor? See here, the ripple factor is defined as the ratio of RMS value of the AC component present in the rectified output to the DC component present in the rectified output. Is the ratio of RMS value of AC component to the DC component at the output side. So this we can write ripple factor equal to IAC by IDC. IAC by IDC. So it is the ratio of RMS value of AC component to the DC component at the output. Ripple factor. So we know that IRMS and IDC values. So substitute these two. So here IAC, see here, IAC and IDC. So if substitute this IDC and IAC values in the definition of the ripple factor. So it is IAC by IDC. It becomes, if you substitute this in this equation, then you will get ripple factor is 1.21. So here the amount of AC present in the output is 121% of the DC voltage. Okay. In the half wave rectifier output, we are having more AC content than DC content. So that's why the ripple factor is 1.21. That means the amount of AC present in the output is 121% of the DC voltage. So in the output of half wave rectifier, the DC output is less than the AC output. So AC quantity is more than the DC quantity. Okay. So here the ripple factor is 1.21 and the efficiency is 40.6% in the half wave rectifier. We see the advantage of half wave rectifier. So it contains only one diode. Only one diode is required. There is no center tap transformer. No center tap transformer is required. Here the peak inverse voltage is same as secondary output voltage. The peak inverse voltage is only V maximum. PIV equal V maximum. The peak inverse voltage is V maximum. Right? So the advantages are only one diode is required for the half wave rectifier and there is no center tap transformer required. And there is no center tap transformer. And the peak inverse voltage is V maximum. The disadvantage of half wave rectifier. Here the ripple factor is high and the efficiency is low. The ripple factor is high and the efficiency is low. Okay. So these are the drawbacks of half wave rectifier. Here only efficiency is 40.6%. So that's why the efficiency is low and the ripple factor is high. The ripple factor is 1.21. So in the output side, the AC quantity is more than DC quantity. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of half wave rectifier. Okay. So the ripple factor is 1.21 and the efficiency is 40.6%. IRMS equal to Im by 2, IDC equal to Im by pi. Okay. So it is about working of half wave rectifier. So with this, I am going to stop the presentation. Thank you.